like to call to order the West Point Village Board meeting of March 14th, 2019, to order at 6:00 PM and ask Clerk Simsky for roll call.
Mayor Gunther?
Here.
The clerk's here. Trustee Addington?
Here.
Trustee Barker?
Here.
Trustee Barry?
Here.
Are you all asleep or something? Trustee Guzzo?
Here.
Trustee Little?
Here.
Trustee Nero?
Here.
Attorney Zimmanek?
Here.
Village Manager May?
Here.
And Finance Director Parker?
Here.
I'd like everybody to please rise, and I'd ask the Boy Scouts to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I'd like to welcome everyone to our meeting. And the first item is open forum. Again, this is the opportunity for anybody to talk about any item that's not on the agenda. Seeing no one, close open forum and move on to reports. My reports first. The student exchange trip to Taiwan will leave March 22nd. So pretty much a week from now, from tomorrow, we'll be sending our first group of students to Hsinchu County.
They'll be here for how long? 2 weeks?
11, 12 days, Larry? How many days?
About 10 days.
10 days. And again, they get hosted by families just like we hosted the students that came here. The census 2020 will be a complete count committee that's being formed. And who do we appoint as the chair to that, Mr. May?
Well, we're kind of tasking that with Westmont first.
Yeah.
And since the complete count committee was, actually its recommended structure is the, is a diverse cross section of the community and, businesses, residents, faith-based, all of that put together. So it was kind of already resembled the mission of Westmont First as well. So with that, and then staff-wise, Director McIntyre would interface with that too.
And they'll be looking for people to assist with the census. They'll be hiring.
Well, there's that too. So the Census Bureau itself has jobs, part-time jobs related to this effort. And you could do that directly. Up on the screen is the information where you could apply on your own. But the Complete Count Committee is the local effort to ensure that that's, a good, accurate, well-done representation of the community is counted.
Good. All right. I do not have any more, and I'll go to Clerk Simsky.
I just want to remind everybody that yard waste and brush pickup, waste management will start on April 1st, so.
No fooling.
Pardon?
No fooling.
No fooling. No, they're really doing it. You're right. And then I just wanted to thank you again for your kindness and your gifts to Ann Simsky. She was thrilled. She's a quiet lady, so very quiet, and talks very softly. But she was thrilled, and she shows that key to everybody.
Mrs. Simsky turned 100, and she was one of the instrumental people in the community of building downtown, so we honored her last month.
Okay.
I'll move on to Trustee Nero.
Thank you, Mayor. Just a few items. Next Public Works Committee meeting is March 28th here at Village Hall at 4:30 p.m. And then I also just wanted to let the village know, I have a note here to thank the Public Works Director. However, it was my first DuPage County Stormwater Committee meeting, and we unanimously approved a grant. So I'd like to say that I had to whip that vote and get that grant approved. But it was thanks to Director Ramsey and Noriel for submitting the application. Westmont was one of five approved.
51,000.
And it was, 51,000, a $204,000 project. So they paid 25% of the project. It is the detention basement at 61st Street and Richmond Avenue. And staff did comment on what a nice application it was, very thorough, and a good solid project for this grant program. So Obviously, Noriel and Mike did all the work and writing it up, but it was unanimous approval, and everybody was able to help.
Have we received grants before?
I'd like to say no, but I think so, yes. But it's a good first meeting. We had a few other things we talked about, but grants was a big portion of it. Looking forward to what's next. One of the other items was, and it's kind of important to Westmont, is Downers Grove has approved $75,000 for St. Joseph Creek Stream Bank Stabilization Project, which, as we know, St. Joseph Creek runs through Westmont, and I'm sure there's some effect there as well. So, other than that, though, Mayor, that's all I have. Thanks to Public Works again for submitting it and taking advantage of it.
Good, thank you. Trustee Little.
A lot of projects, too, I should say. Sorry.
Trustee Little.
Thank you, Mayor. A couple of items. Westmont Community Awards Dinner will be held April 29th. It's a Monday night at the Hilton at 6 o'clock. The tickets are available at www.westmontchamber.com. There's 12 major awards presented by Westmont community organizations, including Westmont Citizen of the Year. So make sure you turn out for that. That's always a good evening. Also, we have the Irish Swig and Jig, or Jig and Swig, event this Saturday, March 16th from 2 to 6. Tickets are available online. What happened? It disappeared. Oh, okay. Tickets are available online at westmontevents.com. They're only $15. You go through five different locations. They have events happening at each location. You get a t-shirt, you get a bus ride. It's a lot of fun. And then I think I'd like to invite Larry up to talk, Larry McIntyre, talk about the Westmont is Bestmont contest.
Thank you. We just quickly wanted to show the four entries that, or the five entries that had won honorable mention and standout presentation for the Westmont is Bestmont contest. In the K through fourth grade, we had Raphael Potasil. And then in the fifth through eighth grade, we had Alice Liu. You can see a lot of detail in that of downtown and throughout Westmont, actually. The ninth through 12th grade submission was from Pranav Viswanath. Everybody knows Pranav. He's involved with everything we do. And actually, the Viswanath family had all of their family members participate, so all three kids were part of it. That was awesome. And then in the next one, we had two adult groups. Age group one was won by Nicole Menes, and these were images that she took up at Ty Warner Park. And then the final entry winner was the Manning Dads, which is a local group. But we had over 20 people participate in the contest, and there was a lot of enthusiasm, so it was fun to recognize them and present them with those awards. So thank you.
Thank you. We did that at the administration finance committee meeting that ran just ahead of this meeting. So it was a lovely event. And that's all I have. Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you. Trustee Barker.
Thank you, Mayor. Couple of things this evening. The EIC committee is participating with the library in a green speaker series, and that'll run through April. And then they also, EIC is gearing up for two events. One is the DuPage River Sweep, which is scheduled for May 18th, and the storm drain stenciling, which we do on an annual basis, has been moved to June 1st. And we're looking for volunteers, Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts, families in town, anybody, sports teams. But it takes a great number of volunteers for both of those projects, and we welcome the help. And then on Monday evening, Westmont First has a meeting at 6 p.m. at the library. We're excited about this. This is our artist roundtable discussion. And I personally called our dance companies and our artist-related businesses to encourage them to participate in this, and this gives us a chance to bring the art community together and find out what the village has going on as far as the arts. We're very proud of the work we're doing with the mural, and we want to hear what they do in our community and what we can do to work with them. So we're excited about that.
And that's open to the public?
That's open to the public.
It's 6 o'clock, it says, right? Okay.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you. Trustee Addington.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Mayor. A couple of things. First one is to, again, do a reminder to everyone, as I did 2 weeks ago. Don't forget, if you haven't done it yet, get your house numbers on the back by your alley in a prominent place, either on your fence or on the garage, so that if public safety has to come down that alley looking for an address, it's plainly visible. There is some penalties if you don't do that, so time is of the essence. I think we're giving out warnings for a while, and then after that, there will be fines if you haven't done it. The other thing is, just to, as a heads up, we had a presentation also at Administration and Finance from one of our new Lions Club members. Lion Dan is thinking of an event downtown that would include eventually expanding into some sanctioned 5 and 10K runs, along with a car show, some an art show, and some other things. Could be a big event, and he wants to do it right here in the parking lot in front of Village Hall. So you'll hear more about that as time goes along, and that's all I have, sir.
Thank you. Trustee Guzzo.
Thank you, Mayor. A couple things. Our next Public Safety Committee meeting will be Thursday, May 23rd, here at 4:30. Everyone is invited to attend. For the fire department, social media. Westmont Fire Department will have its own Facebook page soon. Be sure to like it. Then, on last Saturday, our Emergency Management Association hosted a severe weather training. It was put on by ABC7's Larry Mowry. I actually had the opportunity to attend it. I want to take the opportunity to thank Larry. He was great. We learned so much. He had so many visuals, and it was just really nice to see, especially since we are starting Severe Weather Month. So I do want to say thank you to EMA and to Larry. And then last, but definitely not least, there's a picture of the severe weather class. I want to say we had, what, about 25, 30 people? So it was really well attended, so thank you. And then it is that time of the year again. The St. John Council of the Knights of Columbus is once again holding its Friday night fish fries. They go from March 8th through April 19th from 5 to 8 p.m. And the Knights of Columbus Hall is at 25 North Cass Avenue. Come on down, get some fish, see people you see. And it's just a really nice gathering, and I want to say they do a really nice job on that as well. And that's all I have, Mayor.
Well, thank you. Trustee Barry.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Our next Economic Development Committee meeting will be here at Village Hall on April 3rd at 9 a.m., and we encourage everyone to come and participate. We just had our third annual Westmont Restaurant Week, and we book it as a success. We're getting all the final numbers in right now, but now is the time to vote on your favorites by category. And I think we have a visual, or we'll use this one. I'm not sure. Do you have this one up there, Larry? Is that the one we want? So we encourage everyone to vote now through April 13th, and it's at westmontchamber.com. And now this is typical of Chicago elections. You can vote early and often. It's not just a one-time thing. So we encourage everyone to get on there and vote for your favorite category and favorite restaurants, and then we will report back to you on our winners. Okay. And then the last thing I have, I'm going to take a line from you, Jenny. Everyone should shut off their TVs now and get over to the Neat Restaurant. There is a fundraiser for Katie Conquers Cancer going on this evening, and we encourage everyone to go out there. There's all kinds of raffle prizes. I know Trustee Little has been very involved with that, and so we encourage everyone to shut off their TVs now and go right to the Neat, and we will see them after the meeting.
Okay. How late does that go?
I believe till 9?
Till 9 o'clock.
Till 9 o'clock. Okay.
Till 9.
So. Thank you.
So, very good. Thank you. That's all I have, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. Moving on. Items to be removed from the consent agenda. Any board members see any item? If not, I'd ask Manager May to please read.
First on the consent agenda this evening are Village Board minutes. Board to consider approving the minutes of the Village Board meeting held February 28th, 2019. That's followed by Finance Ordinance Number 22 in the amount of $1,537,021.97. We have four purchase orders. First is to Corin Main LP for $43,024. This is for water meter product. Second is KH Renovations, $75,026. This is actually a an encumbering purchase order for the total amount balance remaining. You'll also find a $16,077 payout for this month in the finance ordinance. Third purchase order is a Benistar Hartford, $30,000. This is for cumulative, the retiree medical health insurance for the remainder of the fiscal year, so also an encumbering amount. But this, all of this money is recaptured by the retiree, so they pass it through. We pay it, but we also collect it. Fourth, Quarterly Corporation, $23,834 for Beast Evidence Software. And forgive me, I forget what Beast stands for, but the four purchase orders total $171,884. Brings the total of purchase orders and finance ordinance number 22 to $1,708,905.97. Lastly, we have one community event for the 2019 Taste of Westmont, but consists of several parts. Board to consider an ordinance approving the following requests from the Westmont Special Events Corporation for the 2019 Taste of Westmont event. First is the special event liquor license fee waiver. Second, amusement license fee waiver. Third, tent permit fee waiver. Fourth, live amplified sound permit for the event hours. And fifth, street and public right-of-way closures in a plan. All of these requests match the event from the previous year and the years before. There's nothing new here. That concludes that item and the consent agenda.
Do I have a motion to approve as read?
Motion to approve, Addington.
Second, Nero.
Motion made and second. On the question. Seeing no one, roll call, please.
Trustee Addington.
Yes.
Trustee Guzzo.
Yes.
Trustee Barker.
Yes.
Trustee Little.
Yes.
Trustee Barry.
Yes.
Trustee Nero.
Yes.
Motion passes. Moving on, new business. A, municipal advisor agreement. Board to consider an ordinance approving an agreement appointing Raymond James as our municipal advisor. Finance Director Parker.
This is something that was discussed in more detail at the Administration and Finance Committee meeting in February. And at that time, the committee recommended to select Raymond James as our municipal advisor. Some of the factors they considered was the fact that of the three respondents we had, Raymond James had the lowest fee, and also they've got a great history of working with the village. We've used them before as our underwriter and have been very happy with the service we've received, and the rating that they've been able to help us get is on the calls with the rating agencies, the preparation they've done with us. If there are any questions, we do have Tom Chapman from Raymond James here to answer any questions if there are questions about the appointment as municipal advisor.
Do I have a motion?
Motion to approve, Nero.
Second, Little.
Motion made and second to approve as presented. On the question.
Tom, what town are you located in?
We're in downtown Chicago.
Downtown Chicago.
And we've had an opportunity to ask a lot of questions prior to this, so I think it's pretty much the same as our last bond issue and the one before that. So, seeing no other questions, I'd ask for a roll call.
Trustee Nero.
Yes.
Trustee Barry.
Yes.
Trustee Little.
Yes.
Trustee Barker.
Yes.
Trustee Guzzo.
Yes.
Trustee Annie.
Yes.
Motion passes. New business B, public works facility bonds. Board to consider ordinance authorizing the issuance of general obligation bonds, which are alternate revenue source series 2019 in one or more series of the Village of Westmont, DuPage County, Illinois, in an aggregate principal amount not to exceed $17,500,000 for the purpose of financing the costs of certain capital projects within the village and paying for costs related thereto. Finance Director Parker.
This is also something that's been discussed several times. We discussed it in a lot of detail at the Administration Finance Committee meeting just immediately before this board meeting. There's a lot of discussion on this. This is also something that's been discussed at several different committee meetings, and then as the determination was made that we needed to proceed with a public works facility and we're looking at options to cover financing for it. We also held a couple of community meetings inviting members of the public to come out to look at the facility, to understand the need for the new facility, which is based both on the condition of the facility, the age of the facility in general, and then also some EPA requirements from the state. And so at that time, the community came out, had a couple of meetings, the village board met again and has passed some measures to be able to start funding the bond issuance. So now our next step is to issue this parameters resolution, to issue this item that says we're intending to issue bonds, things will be published in the paper, and there'll be more steps going forward. So Tom Chapman, again, from Raymond James, is here if there are any questions about this. This was discussed in a lot more detail at the last meeting.
And we received a calendar listing the different dates.
Yes.
Do I have a motion?
Motion to approve, Little.
Second, Addington.
Motion made and second. Additional comments? Seeing none, I'd ask for a roll call, please.
Trustee Little.
Yes.
Trustee Barry.
Yes.
Trustee Addington.
Yes.
Trustee Nero.
Yes.
Trustee Guzzo.
Yes.
Trustee Barker.
Yes.
Motion passes. New business C, Illinois Commerce Commission stipulated agreement. Board to consider an ordinance authorizing an agreement from the Illinois Commerce Commission Transportation Bureau Rail Safety Section concerning installation of pavement delineators,
boy,
at grade crossings along the BNSF line. Manager May.
Yeah, the delineators they're referencing are the white plastic posts that are along the what would be the shoulder line at the crossing as a visual deterrent, keep motorists straight across the crossing. We have, you know, intersections, both frontages, and it's, we've had one instance here, but it's not uncommon for cars to turn off the crossing and end up on the track. So that's the purpose of it. Ours were installed a few years ago, and they were put in, and they were put in by BNSF themselves. And it says this agreement is a 2002 agreement, which is correct, but we're kind of doing it retroactively. They weren't installed in 2002, but their ability with the ICC to do such a thing was, and we have no obligation, there's no cost. Our responsibility is pretty much limited to when we find them in disrepair, we'll report it. So it's easy, and I recommend approval.
Do I have a motion?
So moved, Addington.
Second, Barry.
Motion made and second to approve. And on a question. Roll call, please.
Trustee Addington.
Yes.
Trustee Barry.
Yes.
Trustee Little.
Yes.
Trustee Barker.
Yes.
Trustee Guzzo.
Yes.
Trustee Nemo.
Yes. Motion passes. New business D, 2019 Village of Westmont official zoning map. Board to consider ordinance approving the revised Village of Westmont zoning map dated December 31st, 2018 as the official 2019 zoning map. Director Sylvester.
Mr. Mayor, very briefly, this is a requirement from the state of Illinois. Each year a municipality has to publish their official zoning map reflecting any changes that were made to the map in the previous year. Staff recommends approval.
Do I have a motion?
So
motion
moved,
to
Guzzo.
Approve, Little.
Second, Nero.
Whoa, hang on, I got Marie first.
Stop. Motion has been made and second. You get who made that? Yeah. Second, all right, on the question.
God.
This is an annual event,
yeah,
that's required.
Yes. It's an annual event. I guess I wanted to add that we publish more than one map throughout the year, but the requirement is to publish the one, as Bruce mentioned, for the previous calendar year. So that's why the map is dated December 31st of 2018, even though it's our 2019 zoning map. And the version you have are the condition of the village on that date.
Additional comments?
Well, I have to ask, who seconded it?
I knew it.
I had Little as the, and I had you as the second. And then you all kicked in, so I don't know. Anyway.
Just say everybody seconded.
That's why I just
a third and a
wrote
fourth
down the two I heard.
Any additional comments?
We need longer agendas.
I know. Under miscellaneous, I'll tell you why we I'd ask for a roll call, please.
Trustee Little.
Yes.
Trustee Barry.
Yes.
Trustee Addington.
Yes.
Trustee Nero.
Yes.
Trustee Guzzo.
Yes.
Trustee Barker.
Yes.
Motion passes. Miscellaneous. I have one item.
Uh-oh.
And I know Trustee Barker said we need longer agendas. Well, you heard me comment that the that our zoning, planning and zoning, does a lot of the work.
Mm-hmm.
And I met today with Chairman Pill, and he recommended the board watch last night's three-hour meeting that was continued. And he said that they had a lot of people testifying, and he, so that's the work they do. They do all the lifting, and we get to see the results. So they're doing a great job. But if you haven't watched it, I haven't. I'm going to watch it because he says there are a lot of individuals.
Was it all on one topic?
Yes. They only had two topics. So it was on the Ogden Avenue development.
Okay. Commissioner Pill does a good job of getting people to watch that meeting. So he, and I will say it's very helpful for us here to see John and Bruce and everyone really does a great job there. And of course, all the staff there with Greg. So it's very helpful. It's been very helpful on Garbo and a couple of those situations when you can watch
it. No question.
Other miscellaneous items? Anybody, staff? Nothing. All right. Since Chief Weiss leaves, we have a quick meeting.
Yeah. God.
And Chief Gunther isn't here either.
Oh, all right.
And neither's Tom
Moore. Yeah. You know, don't forget, too.
Can I have a motion to adjourn?
Tomorrow night is Chief Weiss' retirement party.
Second, little.
Motion been made and second to adjourn the meeting. Roll call, please.
Trustee Guzzo?
Yes.
Trustee Nero?
Yes.
Trustee Barker?
Yes.
Trustee Barry?
Yes.
Trustee Little?
Yes.
Trustee Addington?
Yes.
I'd like to thank everyone. This meeting is adjourned.